What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to another video. We are diving into another bullet point for the upcoming Scream 5 spoilers. Now, again, this is a spoiler video, so if you want to click away, I completely understand. I'd appreciate you hitting the like button before you go. Helps out the channel, gets this out to people that don't mind spoilers, and I truly appreciate it. If you're somebody that's just coming in and haven't seen any of these other videos, I'm going over the various points of the spoilers that were leaked for the Scream 5 film. I made a video, I'll link it down in the description below, on all of the spoilers, but per request by many of you, you wanted me to go over the various topic points and give my opinion and have an overall discussion, so make sure you join it down in the comments below. If you're still here, hit that like button, helps me out a lot, lets me know you enjoy these types of videos, and I truly appreciate it. If you're not subscribed to the channel, what are you doing? Hit that subscribe button, follow up with the bell notification so you never miss an upload, stay up to date with all things Scream, join this wonderful community and all of our discussions. So 3, 2, 1, okay, let's get into these spoilers. All right, everyone, I have 2 points that I want to lump together because they fit perfectly. And so I'm going to read these real quick and then we will have our discussion per usual. So let me jump into it. Sam being the killer is a fake out, an effective one. And her fate is single-handedly saved by Sydney in a situation where Sydney has every reason not to trust her. There is a really nice moment where Sid kind of hands the baton to Sam, and Sam is our new final girl. So before we really dive into it, if you haven't seen the previous spoiler, the one right before this one with the twist of the actual film, I highly recommend you checking that out. Arguably it's the biggest spoiler out of all of these, but besides that, it kind of ties into this and is a good transition. But branching off of these 2 points, we know that Sam is sort of positioned as Ghostface, or having this involvement. And as we discussed in the previous spoiler, you have all of these points throughout the film that, and timing lines up and everything matches perfect to Sam being a Ghostface. So they're going to kind of present her as this Ghostface. And given the twist that we know now of what is really going on with Sam, it's a perfect sort of full circle moment. Sydney comes in, she saves Sam when she probably should be not trusting her. Sydney's probably putting herself, from what it sounds like, in a very vulnerable situation, hoping that her gut is right on Sam, which is an awesome and amazing moment, especially as it says, there's a moment where Sydney sort of passes the baton to Sam as the new final girl. What that moment exactly is and what that entails, we do not know all the details at this time for that. But I would assume the way it'll play out, Sam is this Ghostface, red herring the entire time, that transitions into the major twist. The major twist has everyone go, she is Ghostface, oh my god, boom, and everyone thinks it's a mid-film reveal, and it has to be her, and then as it carries on, Sydney is presented with a decision of, do I save her, and if I do, and she's Ghostface, I'm dead. Or do I trust my gut, save her, because she's not Ghostface? And clearly, she chooses the decision to save her, which just goes and ties in perfectly into Sydney's character. I mean, that is Sydney, right? Sydney is the one that, regardless of everything that she has, you can argue she's too trusting, she's too caring, and given what has gone on in her life, you would think she'd have that distance. Now, that doesn't mean that she's not going to have that resistance, and that we talked on a point earlier where she's very, weary and cautious about everyone involved. Yet, Sydney has this sort of motherly undertone to her. She's very motherly to some of the characters, Sam, things like that. So maybe she had this connection and this bond developed through Sam, especially if Sydney knows what the twist is, the twist of the film. If Sydney was already aware ahead of time, or maybe she found out at this point in the film, it would make a ton of sense that she would, one, be cautious and be like, whoa. But having that related ties to Sam is a perfect sort of transition, perfect bonding point, and really, again, is a great full circle moment, because you have these two characters. You have the old OG final girl, the one that is so heralded, beloved, that all of us just can't live without, transition into the new final girl and sort of pass the baton, that it's going to be an excellent moment. And they have to set that up perfectly, which it seems like that is going to be the case. It appears that we're going to get that excellent full circle moment, that transition into one final girl to another. They have said that this is probably the last film for the OG3. That doesn't mean any of them are dying. This doesn't mean that Sydney is dying. Her passing on the baton doesn't mean that she lives or dies. That's not a confirmation for or against. But very likely, this will be the last film for the OG3. I mean, Sydney took a lot of persuading to actually get into this film and have her, or Nev, be the actress to continue, because she really didn't want to. She basically swore off Scream films after Wes Craven had passed, you know, rest in peace. Courtney, she wanted to be killed off in Scream 4, and yes, a lot of time has passed, maybe she's changed her mind, but it's very likely she wants to be done, so she transitions, moves on. Same thing with David. I think David is the only one that really, like, because he was the first one to sign up for this film, he's really excited. Like, even he had an interview recently with Drew Barrymore, and he's just ranting and raving about it. Like, you can tell he's genuinely passionate, genuinely excited for this film. He's a little quirky and stuff. It's just a great moment. But if anyone's going to continue these films, I could see him doing it. Although, I've said this in the past, I'm pretty confident he's going to die at some point in this film. But we don't have any confirmation for or against that, so who knows. But back to the main point, is that so it would make sense that they need to transition, they need to move off the OG3 regardless, at some point, whether it's this film or another film. And judging on the information that we have for this film, it makes a lot of sense that this is a perfect transition film. You have Sydney, she gets sucked in, she has to make the ultimate decision, almost like a sacrificial moment of like, do I save this girl that I don't know, that I don't really trust because she doesn't? Do I save her and run the risk of getting myself killed? Or do I just let whatever happens save myself and figure this out later on down the road? And she ends up making the decision to save Sam, which I think is beautiful, and it shows the character that Sydney is. It shows the trustingness and the love and just the way her character is as a person, and just speaks volumes for that. And so she saves Sam, and then that will probably transition, you know, maybe you'll get a scene or two in between, but most likely will be the transition into the final act of the film. And then there you'll probably see at some point that passing of the baton. Sam has to step up and be the hero that we want it to be. I'll be curious to see how much Sydney actually plays a role in the final act. I would assume maybe it's a group effort. You know, maybe Sam and Sydney side by side take out this ghost face. I could see something along those lines. Because, again, they're trying to build this film around Tara and Sam. Now, what's Tara's fate at this point in the film? We don't really know, but let's assume she is alive. Because I've said I could see Tara and Sam being the sort of Sydney and Gale, you know, like, type, as far as like an OG3. You're transitioning from the OG3 to the new 3. So very likely you're going to get two girls and a guy that are going to carry over into Scream 6. We know that this is supposed to be a trilogy, so it makes a ton of sense. So if Sam takes over as the new Sydney, and the whole film, we believe it's going to be Tara, then we get that nice transition. Boom, Sam becomes the new Sydney. It's very likely you'll have Tara sort of be, not like Gale as like a reporter or her attitude or any or her character herself, but just like the Sydney, Dewey, Gale, you'll have a Tara, Sam, or Sam, Tara, and then whoever the guy is that survives. You get that nice transition. So they have to transition at some point, setting up Sam as the final girl, as the one that's going to carry on this legacy and carry on this franchise. I can see them absolutely having her be the one to kind of finish this whole thing. Like, she's the one that confronts Ghostface. She plays the Sydney role at the end. She has to go and confront her past. She has to go in and confront what the main plot twist has going on, and then boom, that transitions into the end of the film, maybe Sydney has a part in that end. You know, there's references to a line that she says in the film. I could see her maybe coming, or maybe that saving moment is at the end. Maybe that is the final act. You know, maybe Sam goes to confront all that and does all that stuff, and Sydney is the one that has to make the decision. She makes the decision, she saves her, and maybe Sydney's the one to kill Ghostface. I mean, there's several directions they could go with this, but you know, as you start piecing it together, it makes a ton of sense. But overall, I'm really enjoying these twists and these spoilers. The reason I didn't really explain what the main plot twist is through this, and I've been kind of very vague about it, is just, and even though this is a spoiler film, that is a very significant spoiler. And I don't, and there's some people that don't mind a little spoilers, but something like that, I mean, that's the spoiler for essentially the entire film. So I don't want to spoil that for somebody that doesn't want that, where that video actually gives you the chance to know what you're getting into, where this is something completely irrelevant but still ties in. So that's kind of why I was very vague with that. But as always, this is a discussion and I want to hear from you. So let me know what you think down in the comments below. Do you like the idea of Sam transitioning into the final girl? Do you agree that they need to move off the OG three? You know, however you feel about it, whether they kill him, whether they have him survive, whether they, however they decide to transition, do you think now is the time to do so? And now you have Scream 6 and 7, because again, this is supposed to be a trilogy. You have those next two films without the OG 3, these new group of characters that survived, and they transition and continue this legacy into this trilogy. This seems to be sort of the end of the Sydney story. And I want to know what you think down in the comments below. If you haven't liked this video, hit that like button. Helps me out a lot. Lets me know you enjoy these types of videos, and I truly appreciate it. If you're not subscribed to the channel, what are you doing? Hit that subscribe button, follow by the bell notifications, stay up to date with all things Scream, join this wonderful community and all of our discussions, and I will see you all in the next one. Thank you.